Hello, time for Reading with Miss Nickerson, and we are reading another story from the Marvel Storybook Collection. Today, it is called Spider-Man Shock and Awe. Peter Parker, the superhero known as Spider-Man, sat down on a rooftop ledge after a night of fighting baddies. He let out a long sigh. Okay, said Gwen Stacy, Peter's friend and superhero partner known as Ghost Spider. Spill it. What's wrong? Huh? Said Peter, confused. Oh, sorry, I'm just tired. I haven't slept. He rubbed his forehead. There have been these robberies, and I can't figure out who's doing them. Well, talk to me, Gwen said. Maybe you just need a fresh set of eyes. I mean, ears. Every night, a couple of technology targets are hit, Peter began. Computer shops, tech startups, places like that. And at every location, he continued, the security systems are shorted out. They're completely fried. I figured it was Electro, but I checked. He's behind bars. Peter looked defeated. So if it's not Electro, then who could it be? He wondered aloud. That's odd. There have been a string of robberies in my neighborhood, too, Gwen said. Homes, a grocery, even a toy store. But there's no sign of forced entry at any of them. I don't even know how the thief is getting in. When I tried to find out, the only thing I could find was some wet footprints. All the crime scenes had them. You know what? Said Peter. I think I've got yours figured out. Then we've got that in common, Gwen said triumphantly. Because I know who's robbing those electronic stores. The friends grinned. Gwen and Peter put their heads together, working out detail after detail, idea after idea. They found that in using one another's strengths, they made a pretty good team. All they had to do was build the trap, or, in their case, a web. The first thing they needed to do was find a target that would attract both criminals. An empty storefront in Gwen's neighborhood fit the bill perfectly. With a freshly printed banner and a foggy front window, they disguised the storefront as an up-and-coming electronic shop. Peter passed out flyers and Gwen posted on all the top social media sites and tech blogs. Their web had been spun. Now it was just a matter of waiting for the sun to go down. With everything in place, Spider-Man and Ghost Spider perched on the rooftop of their fake store. They waited in silence, hoping to spot anything unusual.
Yawn.
Spider-Man was having trouble keeping his eyes open, but suddenly his spider sense jolted him wide awake. He scanned the street below and saw a thin stream of water making its way toward the building. It was as if the water was alive. The water slid underneath the store's metal shutter. It moved a few feet into the dark room and lifted itself up into the air. Slowly but surely, it took the shape of a person. There stood the villain Spider-Man suspected had been ransacking Ghost Spider's neighborhood. Hydro-Man. Meanwhile, Ghost Spider spotted a shadowy figure approaching the back of the building. She ducked down low, keeping her gaze on the mysterious stranger. Electricity shot out of the figure's hands and into the automatic lock on the back door. Ghost Spider smiled beneath her mask. I knew it, she whispered. Her gaze met Spider-Man, and with a nod, they took action. Inside the store, the shadowy figure's hands began to glow. Spider-Man's suspicions had been correct. Electro was behind the rash of recent tech robberies. Just not the Electro he'd thought. There in the darkness was the newest electrically powered villain to plague New York City, Francine Fry. The first thing Electro noticed was that this store wasn't much of a store at all. The second thing she noticed was a dark figure standing at the opposite end of the large room. It's a trap, Electro thought. She immediately disengaged her electric charge. Now more than ever, she would need to stick to the shadows. Across the store, Hydro-Man saw a spark of light out of the corner of his eye. He strained to see in the darkness. He could only make out a dark shadow standing by the open back door. Someone was waiting for him. Hydro-Man clenched his fists. He was not one to give up without a fight. The two villains bided their time for a beat. Then, at nearly the exact same time, Hydro-Man lashed out with a blast of water while Electro shot a giant bolt of electricity from her hands. Crack. Lightning met water in a tremendous explosion. Sparks, smoke, and steam filled the room. Ghost Spider took advantage of the chaos and leapt forward toward Electro, keeping her from causing further damage and mayhem. Hydro-Man staggered backward. He had received such a shock to his system, he couldn't even think about turning into water at the moment. It was all he could do to try to keep his balance. Just then, Spider-Man leapt from the shadows. "So this is what happens when you don't pay your water bill," he joked as he shot a web toward his opponent. Hydro-Man hit the floor with a thud. He was down for the count. Later, back on the rooftop, the heroes watched as S.H.I.E.L.D. agents carted away the two villains. "What did I tell you?" Gwen said happily. "A fresh perspective was all either of us needed. Now you can go home and finally get some rest." But Peter didn't answer. He had fallen asleep 10 minutes ago. The end.